I'm at SeaWolf Records, just outside of center Amsterdam in Zuid. It's owned by DJ Sank and Andy Perfetti. They basically would sell records out of the basement. Then they opened the shop. 5 years later, boom, you got an amazing selection of house, disco, techno, everything you could ask for, but it's all basically private collections bought and then cataloged and resold. So gems everywhere. I'm standing in front of the Detroit section, which seems odd, but there's a lot of old Detroit records that I either ran through as far as wearing them out, playing them, and they're not pressed anymore, so I always look. So I usually start in the Detroit section, then I move on to Chicago, a lot of old Chicago booty music, Chicago house. Time to dig. Oh, see, already. What is this, Vice? See, another reason that I look, and I can tell when these records were pressed, is I look at the phone number. So if I know an old ass 313 phone number that doesn't work anymore, I know that that's original pressing. A lot of Kevin Saunderson. Oh yeah, a lot of Kevin Saunderson. Stop the presses. Moody Man. See, you can't go wrong with the old S Moody Man, I swear. Yeah, classic. You can't just find that. You can't just go online and find that. You know what I mean? But yeah, I did the remix for Kevin. Four, E-Dancer. And I just found E-Dancer. I didn't remix these, but you can't beat an extra copy of Grab the Beat or Pump the Move. A lot of these I have, but you gotta, I just think about the condition that they're in. Damn, this is a nice rare Planet E. Private collections, I swear. See, some of these I don't even have. An old ass paperclip people with the paperclip on it. Old school. That's so funny. I used to live in the same building with Carl too. It was Carl, Kelly Han, rest in peace. And Carl had a roommate, his name was DJ Overdose. And then I lived on the third floor. And then one of the singers from Members of the House lived on the fourth floor. And it was just, the building was crazy. There's just so much music in that building. When people always talk about it and they say it was the best parties and all back in the day, it was. I mean, seriously, if you have a party now and you have a lineup with three headliners, everybody's freaking out. They're like, that's dope. In Detroit, you have a party where it could be D-Win, Dan Bell, Kevin Saunderson, Richie Hawtin, John Acquaviva, Mike Huckabee, Blake Baxter, you know, myself. And at the time, younger, you know, I was one of the younger guys, so I was happy to be included in parties like that. So you get these big ass lineups like that. There were parties where it would just be a flyer with a number and you would call the number and it would tell you where the party is. But then you get there and then you don't even know who's playing. I went to one party, they told me to bring my records. It was me, Richie, John Acquaviva, and somebody else. And basically whoever was there would play. And you play until the crowd either gets tired or they're not really feeling the music anymore. So some nights you might not even play. If somebody's hot, you never stop them. You don't stop the party. Say, oh, that's your time. You know, I gotta go on now. It's my time. Mm-mm. And if you didn't keep that vibe, if you weren't, you know, bumping, you got to go. In Europe, the standard was usually to play a long set. So they come to Detroit and they're thinking, okay, I'm gonna play this long ass set. And they start playing and like 40 minutes in, people are just like, So they're telling the promoter, look, man, you know, you gotta get this guy off the deck, so we're gonna leave the party. So the promoter still, you know, you pay him and everything. It's just, sorry, man, you gotta stop. And they never understood it. There were very few people, honestly, from Europe who could come to Detroit and just rock that party. Dimitri, Laurent Garnier, every time. It was nothing but love. Whenever they came, then the Detroit DJ would be lucky if they get to play. Back in the day, you know, as they say, it was phenomenal. That's funny, it says the Chicago mixes of Good Life. I haven't seen this before. Oh, this is old school, Steve Silk Hurley. Oh yeah. We used to drive to Chicago, rent a motel room, just get just inside city limits for the radio, and bring our boombox, record Farley and Steve Silk Hurley, the radio mixes, and then drive back the next morning to Detroit. Just so we could have tapes of mixes, you know, some house mixes. That's what happens when you really love it, you know? Oh yeah, another Alias. Kevin Saunders and Chaos. I couldn't keep my sleeves this clean. I would always end up with the record poking out the side or in the bottom because I slam it in there. That's in good shape. Damn, blue vinyl on this. That's the Funky Funk Funk. This is the one that plays Inside Out. I know that one, but not on blue vinyl. It's funny because I was on Instagram and I saw Questlove talking about this record shop in Detroit. called Melodies and Memories. Secondhand records, memorabilia, old lunch boxes and dolls and all this stuff. It was places like that. Each shop had its own character. You know, there's one by Wright, Moody Man worked there, Rick Wilhite worked there. And they were the ones who would be like, oh, Bone likes this, blah, blah, blah. And they pull the records for you and slip you something special from the back. So if something really hot would come in, they have it in the back and they'd be like, hold on, let me go. And they go in the back and they come out. Don't tell nobody, you know. One of the record shops Rob Hood used to work at, it was called Professionals. And it was funny because it was like a hair salon. And then the other side was like this little corner was a record shop. I was showing earlier, I saw this and it said DJ only. And it'll say not for sale. I used to live off of those. All these promos that they would send to these record shops, you're not supposed to sell them, but they would get them in and sell them. So I had all these promo copies, radio only. So I have some like De La Soul white labels with different mixes of stuff that never came out because it didn't test well. When the DJs gave them the feedback, they were like, eh, you know, they didn't really care for this mix. And the cool thing was Rob, or the shop itself, they knew that they weren't really supposed to sell it, so they would price it really cheap. So everyone else would look at it like, man, I'm not trying to get that $2 record. And I'm like, I'm trying to get that $2 record. Because that's got, you know, but all you got to do is you got to stay there for 2, 3, 4 hours and just listen. So now I'm going to move on to some Chicago because there's always some classics that I don't have. The house, the tracks built, all these tracks compilations are always, you can't go wrong. A lot of them weren't mastered really well, and they tried to put too many tracks on one side, so the volume is so low. But I don't care. I still play it. I just turn the gain up. See, this has Ron Hardy, Robert Owens, Frankie Knuckles, Jackmaster D, the original Jackmasters, you know, in Chicago. Oh, shit. I play this all the time. Farley Jackmaster Funk. Ooh, Love Can't Turn Around. Now this is how it started. That's the shit right there. That's the shit. Oof. What's crazy about SeaWolf is it's the cleanest dig that I've ever done. And you know, I was ready, you know? I come ready. I'm like, well, I'm gonna sweat, I'm gonna dig, I'm gonna get my hands. You go to any record shop, you're gonna, you know, you flip through and as soon as you get that whiff, you're like, oh. See, when you see like the old Dance Mania, that's amazing, the Hercules, Seven Ways. That's so cool. It brings back a lot of memories, you know? I'm gonna take all the good stuff. You may as well I can just get a truck, you know, sort it out at home. But I like to dig. I miss digging. Now that's how you dig. They're like, Mom, I thought he was underground. He's drinking Prosecco, his thing out. I always have to take a look at the hip hop section. I started off playing hip hop. That's where I would try and exercise most of my skills. And then I found out about techno. I was like, what, 16, 17. I would hear it on the radio. I didn't know where it came from or what it was called or anything. Then my friend took me to this club called Music Institute. I was too young to get in, so they paid the bouncer to open the back door. And I just heard some of the best music I ever heard in my life. It was literally life-changing. That is the jam. De La Soul. I was always looking at the covers, like this one, Ed O.G. and the Bulldogs. It was worth a listen because they look serious in the motherfucker. You know, they look like they're about their business. So, all right, you got me. I'm gonna take a listen. Yeah, I miss digging like this. Oh yeah, see, things like this. I can tell, I've never seen this before, but it's just called DJ Service Volume 5. So I know what it is. It's a bunch of samples and snippets and all that. Things like this I would look for. Ice-T, Queen Latifah. Oh, and De La Soul. That's so funny. The funny part is this has a CJ McIntosh remix on it. I don't even know if the young people, your young viewers, know who CJ McIntosh is. They can Google it. Yeah, Def Jam samplers back in the day. See, because they were trying to get the radio stations to play. So now on this one, you got Beastie Boys, Fight for Your Right, Public Enemy Time Bomb, LL Cool J, I Need a Beat, Original Concept, Bite My Style, Orange Juice Jones, and there you go, for promotional only, not for sale. These are the ones they would send to the radio station or send to, you know, club DJs. I had this vinyl, see, I don't have it anymore. Back from Hell, Run DMC with Ice Cube and Chuck D. Man, Chuck D is still cold as hell. I was saving my money to get turntables and a mixer, and then my cousin, I won't say his name, it rhymes with Ike with an M in the front, he did the five-finger discount on a mixer and got the turntables, but it was old, I mean belt drive old. So if you would touch the record too much, the belt would slip off, you would have to stop and take it apart. It didn't really work. So I started recording my mixes, my friends would hear him and they would say, can I get a copy of that tape? Can I get a copy? I'm like, okay. So then Thomas Barnett, he came by the crib and he was like, look, I got this guy, Dennis White, who is doing a night down at Shelter, and he's looking for a resident. So I'm gonna give him a tape. I was, all right. So I gave it to him. He said, cool. You know, he listened to it and he said, hey, can you come down? I came down to play. Ended up with a bunch of residencies in Detroit, like five going on almost at this simultaneously. So I was playing from, seriously, from Wednesday to Sunday at a club, one club or the other. Then Laurent Garnier came, played a anniversary party at the club where I first started at Shelter, but I wasn't playing there anymore. And he was asking Matt Mike, he's like, who is this kid? And Mike said, oh, that's Bone, you know, he's a bad brother. Talked to him, he was like, give me 3 months, I'm gonna bring you to Europe. A few months later, 2 months later, maybe three, got a fax come through on my machine, it was Laurent. And he was like, I'm ready to bring you to Paris. Do you want to come? And so I was like, fuck. I didn't know what to do, you know? To know that I was going to go to the Rex to play with Laurent, you know, at his night. You know, it was really cool. So I went, played, amazing experience, you know? Roder took me around Paris, showed me everything. It's phenomenal. He was like, look, I represent Detroit, but if you want to hear real Detroit, you'll come tonight and hear DJ Bone. So the club was packed, and it was packed full of people curious. But Detroit is a pressure cooker, so I wasn't nervous. The DJ booth was air conditioned. You know, I was like, that's like cheating. Disco section, funk disco, Italo disco. You know, I'm in the Italian shop, SeaWolf. My main man, my brother, the best man at my wedding, Paul Storico, always tells me about the best. He's like, this is the best, man, it's the best. Put me up on Italo disco. So this section is gonna be good. It's gonna be special. And I just heard from the SeaWolf crew that a lot of these records, if not the majority of them, most of them, were bought from someone who bought a collection from Paradise Garage and The Loft. I'm about to get in this disco. This is ridiculous. Boogie Woogie Disco Nights. People know those. But then when you get Bombers Don't Stop the Music and get dancing, already, The Loft Classic Series, Home is Where the Hatred Is, oof, and The Chase. You can't beat that. A crisp copy of that? Seriously, this is ridiculous, man. Candido, you have Jingo. You have Jingo. What the fuck? Are you kidding me? What? Jingo Breakdown? The original, Dancing and Prancing acapella? Jingo acapella? Jingo acapella. Seriously. Okay. Ron Hardy, don't even have to look at it. Anything that says Ron Hardy is gold. You got some James Brown. Do you know how difficult this is to find? There's this one break you heard all throughout the 90s in hip hop. And it was doom, doom, da, da, doom, da, doom, da, doom, doom, da, 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 da. Ain't it funky? James Brown, funky drummer. After I digitize this, I'm gonna bring it back here and let them sell it. Secret Weapon must be the music. Damn, see? So this is disco and Italo, okay. See, Under the Loft Classic right there, Whistle Bump. See, that's the old school Paradise Garage. Somebody jacked to put Garage Classics on there. I can go and play a techno set and I will slip something in like Outkast or something. That's just the hip hop in me that still has to do that. You know, or Luke Skywalker or something, Doodoo Brown, you know, you never know. Sometimes I have to do that for me, you know, and that's the least that the crowd can do is give me one record out of 3 hours. You know, for me to, you know, that's my shit right there. A lot of people who have never done it understand it. And if you've never played vinyl, you'll never know it. You can't go from playing digital and say, you know what, I'm gonna go buy some vinyl and see what this Bone's talking about with digging, you know. I respect the culture of vinyl. I respect the history. It's a ritual. It's just a straight up ritual. I'm gonna listen to a few of these. I have an old school hip hop sampler. So the young people, listen up. And we have classic LL Cool J. I have some Eric B and Rakim. See, that's why, yeah. That's why I end up with these kind of compilations, unauthorized, because they have different mixes on it. So this is a different mix from the original right now. I came in the door I said it before, I never let the mic magnetize me no more, but fight me. So now you got audio two. So what I do when I'm listening to the vinyl is I'm basically listening to make sure it's the track that I thought it was, or if I haven't heard it before, I'm trying to figure out if I like it. So I go through it really quick, and then I take a few to listen to. Of course, one of my favorites, Farley Jack Master Funk. So this, even today, you play this in a house set, and the place is just gonna go off. I mean, you can't beat that. Next, I'm gonna check out, I'm very curious about this Inside Out. I think this is it, from Reese. It's a bass line, the funky funk funk. Let's see what we got. It might be 45. So Detroit had this other infatuation with doing different pressings of records. Like, we would do records that played from the inside out, like this. That's just nasty. I love that. But yeah, it plays from the inside out. Now, I have some more. I know I'm from Detroit, but I mean, Detroit music is in my blood, so forgive me for playing all these Detroit records. This is Carl Craig, AKA Paperclip People. I used to play this at the end of most of my sets at Motor in Detroit. And it's a track, Oscillator. And the way it kicks in is phenomenal. Ooh. So, growing up, this is the bar. This is techno for me. So when people play a 4-4 and it's banging and it's repetitive, that's techno. But for me, this is techno. I'm curious about this Vincent Floyd on Dance Mania. Because Dance Mania was one of those labels where basically it came out like, I don't know, you could get like 4 Dance Mania a week. But most of the time you just buy it. Because it was always good tracks, you know? And the difference between the Detroit and Chicago for me was I could get the same feeling from tracks like this from Chicago, even though they were 4-4, repetitive, direct. The bass line, you know? The bass line, the acid they put in there, the vocals, it'll speak to you. There's something about the simplicity of the Chicago tracks that made them so beautiful. And it was raw too. So it was almost like somebody made the track and they wanted to release it without altering the moment it was recorded. You don't want to over process it. You want to over master it. You just want it to sound like it did. Like you're sitting next to them. To me, it sounds like you're sitting next to them in the studio and they're listening to it on their monitors. Yeah, that's Vincent Floyd featuring Chan on Dance Mania. It's called Technology. This is a Loft Classics record. And what they would do is take classic tracks that were played at the Loft by the DJs there and do a compilation so that people could kind of get the gist of what the vibe was like there. Thank you. Home is where the hatred is. You name it. The bottle. I have the bottle on one of these. So you can hear right there, that shit's funky. Play that out now and see if people won't dance.
That's it. Everybody in the room's face just changed. They were like,
let's see. Gil's got here, one of my all-time favorites, because he spoke the truth to power, and he expressed himself through the music, and that relates to me, because a lot of Detroit artists created their music because they didn't just go in the studio and record. They had to make a song because I got harassed by the police, because I got beat by the cops, because my house got robbed, because I got shot at, because my bills are overdue, something. Oof. And I'm on my way home. That's just phenomenal. I left 3 days ago, and no one seems to know I'm gone. Home is where the hatred is. Yeah, so this one, I couldn't tell what it is. It's direct beat, it's aux 88, but as sometimes happens when you get your labels printed, the shit gets blurry. So they printed on this label like 3 times. So now I can't even tell what the name of the track is. So I'm gonna listen to it. Electro, if you want to call it techno bass, booty, it's all in Detroit's veins. And that's the beat right there. Aux 88, probably the best electro live set I've ever seen, hands down. Very curious about, I think it's an acapella, a jingle acapella. Jingle. Yeah. Jingle bop. Yeah, my wife's in the back. She goes, jingle. Jingle. I've been looking for this for a long, long time. Jingle, just the acapella. Yes, and that's it, it's over. But that's all I needed. I'm gonna see if this is the actual funky drummer from James Brown. Shade. So it is. God, it's a raid. But now, let's see. That's it. Right at the end. And they have this bonus beat. That's it. This has been sampled more than any other sample outside of Parliament Funkadelic. Oh yeah, everybody sampled that. Ain't it funky? Ain't it funky? Even Sinead O'Connor sampled that shit. I'm stretched on your grave. She sampled that. I can't come to the Italian record store and not play some. Oh man. And it's funny because when you play these, people recognize parts because people have sampled them, or I also like the Italo disco because it was a faster pace. It was more energy to it as far as pace goes. now. I got this strobe light honey from Black Sheep. And if people, young people might not know Black Sheep, is they did hip hop, they do hip hop, Dredd still does it. And they did this song, Black Sheep, this or that, this or that. Who's a black sheep? What's a black sheep? So they did a bunch of songs. These hip hop guys did a straight up disco, like house, mix of that track. I used to play this at the shelter.
Yo, I skipped the line, I paid my dime, I hung my coat, and now it's time to move to the forefront, make my round, say peace, and give a pint of a drink, get down. By the door, beside the dance floor, the sound is rich, and my pants are pockets pure. Remember Susie, Wendy, and Judy, we'll look a hop. Yeah, you sweetie, although it's hard to see thee. See a silhouette, and what I see has got me needy. Need it for a second of your time, but then I reckon that a second might be too short. Slam it! But anyway, let me say, I'm dressed up, the black sheep, giving you the play. Step out on the light, come show off yourself.
Yeah, I mean, it's a full circle, you know? I love dropping records like that because people are just sitting there like, they're dancing, but then they're kind of like, they're baffled. The best is when you see someone try and Shazam it, you know? They come up and they're like, and then they get back. Cannot find, and it's, you see their face, you know? They're like, damn. But that's my history, you know? I went from hip hop into techno and then into house, and it progressed, you know? I played everything.